Hi and welcome. In this video, we're going to try to improve the audio quality of the PWM audio of the WavetablePi. If you're not familiar with the WavetablePi project, please take a look at my previous video. In short, it is a wavetable module compatible with the WaveBlaster header that is powered by a Raspberry Pi 02W running MT32Pi. As you may recall from my previous video, the audio quality of the WavetablePi without the high fidelity DAC module was pretty poor. There was just too much noise. Here's a sample. Yeah, it is completely unusable. But let's try to understand what the problem is. None of the Raspberry Pi boards until now have ever had good audio quality. Even those with an actual audio jack, like the Raspberry Pi 3 and 4, don't actually have a proper analog audio circuit. Instead, they generate audio using digital GPIO pins, switching them at high speed using pulse width modulation, PWM. The earlier models had some very simple filtering between the audio jack and the GPIOs. Later models have added a high-speed buffer between the GPIOs and the filter, which improves the audio quality a bit, but it's still quite poor. The Raspberry Pi Zero has none of the above, so it is up to us to filter the output of the GPIOs. In revision 0.2 of the WavetablePi, we were simply getting the audio straight from the GPIO pins, which sounded pretty terrible. Okay, let's take a closer look into how PWM works. PWM stands for pulse width modulation, and it is a fancy term for describing pulsing a signal with variable on-off periods. It is a way to generate an analog signal from a digital output. For example, if we need an analog signal at the level of the green line, but we only have in our disposal a digital output, then we can simply switch it on for 50% of the time and off for the rest 50%, which averages out at about the level of the green line. By changing the on-off period of the digital signal, we can emulate any sort of analog signal. The Raspberry Pi uses its method to generate analog audio, which obviously produces quite a bit of noise. Here is what it looks like in the oscilloscope. The signal at the kilohertz scale is supposed to be smooth, but instead it is very noisy. If we zoom in to a higher frequency, we can actually see the pulses. It is strange though, I would expect them to vary from 0 to 3.3 volts. Instead, as you can see, they produce a signal between 1.2 and 2 volts. If anyone knows why this is the case, please let me know. Okay, now that we know what the problem is, let's try to fix it with some filtering. We can use a simple low-pass filter to try to remove the high-frequency noise. The simplest low-pass filter consists of a resistor and a capacitor, forming a voltage divider. At low frequencies, the capacitor acts as an open circuit, so the voltage divider's output matches the input. As we increase the frequency, the capacitor's reactance increases, so the output of the voltage divider will start decreasing. At some frequency, the capacitor's reactance will match the value of the resistor, so the output voltage will be half that of the input. This is usually referred to as the cutoff frequency. And finally, as we increase the frequency even further, the capacitor will act as a short circuit, connecting the output to ground. For example, if we use a 1K resistor and a 100 nanofarad capacitor, then the capacitor's reactance at 1.6 kHz will be around 1000 ohms. So the cutoff frequency for a filter like this is around 1.6 kHz. Using a smaller capacitor allows higher frequencies to pass. For example, with a 10 nanofarad capacitor, the cutoff frequency is around 16 kHz. Okay, so let's add some filtering to the Raspberry Pi to see whether the audio improves. I hooked up some wires to the audio selection header. The pins on the right are connected straight to the GPIO pins, while the pins in the middle are connected to the wavetable audio pins, with a pair of DC blocking capacitors in between. I experimented with a couple of simple filtering circuits, various resistor and capacitor values. None of them are great, but they all improve the noise quite considerably. I think this is one of the best outputs I got. Now let's do a back-to-back comparison without and with the filter. Here is the original audio coming straight from the GPIOs. Since the filters for the left and right audio channel are identical, I did most of my testing using a single filter feeding both channels. Now let's connect the audio to the filter. It is a lot better. Now let's try out a larger 100 nanofarad capacitor instead of 10 nanofarads. I'm not sure why, but in this configuration the resistors alone made a huge difference in audio quality. I think it sounds pretty good, very little noise is getting through. Now let's try out an even larger 1 microfarad capacitor. Yeah, the cutoff frequency is really low at 150 Hz, so the music sounds very muffled. Now back to the original 10 nanofarad capacitor. It also seems that the 10K resistor between the input and ground reduces the noise a little bit. I don't understand why though. However, the audio output seemed to change depending on the position of the components or when I was touching the circuit, so I'm not sure the audio outcome is fully reproducible. Okay, that's all for now. I have updated the WavetablePi PCB with a simple low-pass filter. This is now revision 0.3. And as always, thanks for watching and goodbye!